Thank you very much. May we ask you to take your seats, except for Dr. Zuling and Dr. Decray. May we invite Dr. Zuling to give his remarks.
But the destruction of our company about it as such, that there was no choice. So that for the three, and for my Lesbian brother, I mean, there was the challenge and the possibility of returning to the country for the death of family before the war. So I left academia precisely because I was continuously interested in economic theory, and I, for those who knew, who have a knowledge of how economic thought is developed, I am an adherent of the Austrian school that has been promoting liberalism to a point that it did not impinge on the public will and allowed for certain limited intervention of governments. Even today, I believe, and I think ought to be, from my viewpoint, the base, the way the international institutions like IMF, etc., the World Bank, could do things. I've been asked what I thought about ASEAN. I was in on the development at a very early stage, and I thought this was a wonderful idea. There were ethnically and for other reasons, there was good sense to establish an identity. The subsequent developments were not quite even. There have been problems, because after all, the countries of Asia are separated by a lot of water. And water is an insulating agent, as we have seen in other places of the world. Now, of course, with the mobility provided by not only the easy communications of these days, but also the travel and so on possibilities, these issues have receded in the background. And anyway, at the time that we looked at the AAM things, no pun intended, the possibility of tying together the community of Asian nations was more vibrant than that even before, when the time of the whole message was totally. Now the challenges for the future are considerable. There is the enormous landmass of China in the back of Asia. There are rivalries in the world, and against all of this we have to steer a clear and determined course. Asia, ASEAN, or ASEAN, has a future, but it must be fully aware of it, and it implies concessions. When I read, as it was the case yesterday, I think, that the Philippines assembles 11,000 cars in 2 months, whereas Thailand assembles a vast multiple of that number, recall that we as company representing Bosch at one time had great hopes that the Philippines could assemble cars. They do, but compared to other countries, to a lesser extent. Now, what I'm aiming at is that there has to be some kind of a concentration of planning, and this has to be done on an economic basis. The political questions should take the hand seat in the interest of the welfare of the people growing living the economic issues of the big presidents. This is about what I want to say in general, but at the same time, I'm extremely happy to be here with you. This is an unexpected and very generous welcome, most gracious, and I say to all of you who are here, thank you very much.
I invite Dr. Ducret to give the closing, the last statement for AIM.
It would have to be a prompt since it's not in the script. I think this has been a delightful event, and it's so good of you, Dr. Zulig, to come back to us. So thank you for your remarks. Obviously, as a business leader, we take your words with extreme interest. We do hope the company continues to prosper. And I don't know if we've introduced David to the audience, but we do have your son here with us, which we're delighted. In fact, he's actually connected to the center, which we're very delighted to have that link. So with that, let me thank, Daniel. I hadn't met him. So let me thank all of you for joining this event, and scholars, good luck to all of you. You have your work cut out for you in and out of the classroom. So thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes our program this morning. Please join us for refreshments and a chance to interact with Dr. Zulig more informally. Thank you very much, and good morning.